There is a saying that the voice of the people is the voice of God. What people say on your behalf matters a lot and could be a true reflection of who you really are.
Ovie, who is today the distinguished leader of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, I regard as a younger brother. I cherish friendship a lot as a person. And I recall that we have a family history of a good relationship between our parents. So I didn't really know of as a younger person when we were growing up. He knew some of my younger ones, but I knew his father because I was always in touch with his father, in between his father and my old man. Both have passed on today. So the children are continuing from where they stopped.
So the daughter of your man is a very humble young man. A man who is highly likable. A man who feels the pulse of the people. A man who knows what these people need, what the Robo people, what they need. A man who has a passion for the Robo nation and wants to do the best for the Robo nation. That's the man that is Ovie Omagwe.
Senator Ovie Omagwe is a leader who is passionate about service to his people. He went to the Senate prepared with a very clear vision and definite plan of what he was going to do to restore the voice of the people of Delta Central and the Senate. So far, he has done a very good job trying to redefine who the Robo people are in terms of representation. As a boss, he's a very passionate person, highly committed and dedicated. In terms of staff welfare, he's just excellent. And so far, it has been a very wonderful experience working with him.
My boss, Senator Yombangiki, is a very pragmatic politician. He's a man who has the interests of his people at heart. He's a man who always wants the best for his people. We resumed 6 months after the inauguration of the 8th Senate. And when we got to the Senate, we immediately got to work. Kept us all on our toes. And they initiated so many bills that they asked us to do some research on. So he's a very intelligent man. Somebody that you want to work with, because he's working within us, really sharpened my knowledge, both in law and in legislative business, because I am a lawyer like himself. He has encouraged me a lot to do my best in whatever assignment he has given. So in all, I would say he's a very good person to work with. He's very generous. Is somebody who wants the best out of everybody that is around him. He's somebody who wants development come to his people. You can see that the empowerment that he impacted on touched the life of the downtrodden. That's where he started from the market women, powering them with stipends to advance their petty trades. So he's a very, very good man, I can say. Somebody more really want to work with.
I recall some years ago, Ovie being a PDP stalwart then, he came to meet me when he wanted to contest for governorship. Came to cultivate my friendship and support. I then asked him why. You know, I'm an opposition leader in the Delta State. Why come to me? And he said one thing, said, Bros, we know you, we know your strength. I don't think I should rely on just PDP alone. I won't be able to get your local government if I rely on PDP alone. That singular action won my heart because it was totally at variance with the attitude of most PDP members and stalwarts. as far as PDP was concerned, they see opposition as enemies. They don't realize that opposition should be seen as partners in progress. It's like you dressing up and looking into the mirror. The mirror will tell you if you are properly dressed or not. Opposition is like that. Unfortunately, PDP that have governed Delta State for so long didn't see it that way. If Obi was a governor, then I'm sure, and he saw it that way as a candidate or as an aspirant to come and meet me in another camp, it means that he would have done something better, unlike it is today. So when there was an opportunity for us to be together, I quickly held on to it, and I decided to relate to him, because he extended a hand of friendship to me. I took that hand, and that's why we are not just members of one party today, Labour Party to APC, but we are brothers that we should be.
The senator is like a political son to me, and we've been together for about 12 years, and I've always been on top of all these political movements, contacts, and reach. We've gone through the campaign and, together. We thank God that at the end of the day, the doctor saw them through so many attempts at governorship. We ended up with the senator.
It was a philosopher that said that failure is not final. This was a man who had come before his people on several occasions to say, please send me, I can do this job for you. And he was turned down on several occasions. You know, but now, of course, going to the Senate was almost more or less like going through the eye of a needle. We campaigned vigorously, going around all the polling units across Delta Central. Not too many people gave us the chance, even though he won convincingly, but you know what happened. The professional election regards who thought that they owned this state went to work and stole the mandate. And of course, he had to go through all of the trouble in the election petition tribunal, and then eventually the appeal court before victory came. And of course, even after that, they also conspired with some powers that be at the National Assembly to say that even though this man had been declared by the appeal court and that he had been given his certificate of return by INEC as required by law, they also refused to swear him in until after a lot of struggle before he was given his rightful seat in the Senate. I can say that, Senator Omagige is a man of steel. He has passed through a lot, and he's very well prepared to continue to give his people efficient and effective service.
The journey so far has been very, very good. What we got to the Senate, we were like 6 months, 7 months behind. But when we got there, it kept all of us on our toes. Because like I said before, he's a very hardworking man, very intelligent. We started work in earnest. Most of the bills that we passed, he initiated them. And he engaged all of us. That's how, why you can see that most of the legislative impact, the bills, the motions that he has moved on the floor of the Senate were very, very impactful. And within a record time, we came out with a lot of bills and motions that touched on the lives of the people. So I can say that so far it's been very good. We've done a lot in terms of bills that were initiated by the distinguished senator like us. Working with him is very, very, very it's exciting, I would say, even though it's challenging, because he's a man that would not want you to sit down idle. He's a man that wants you to work very hard, to put in your best from whatever you are doing. For me personally, he has sharpened my my knowledge, both in law and in the legislative business, that I am happy working with him because I have gained a lot. For the years that I've put in and working with him. So he's somebody that one desires to work with.
It's a welcome development. Well, just like I said, he has a big heart. Some of our followers felt they were not properly consulted. So those that worked, seemingly worked for him, were not direct beneficiaries. And he said, when I listened to him then, when the complaints were coming forth, he said, everybody belong to my constituency. Every person in my constituency I'm representing. Now that I've won, I will not choose A from B. However, I will still address that situation. That is what I'm saying, that I saw in him what I liked, that I appreciated. So initially, when those complaints came, some of our reaction was, Ovie, please look into these complaints. And he said, his own reaction said, Ross, I'm a senator to Delta Central. So whether you are PDP, APC, whatever you are, Labour Party, I'm representing you, so I'm empowering everybody. However, I will address those that have issues. And he really came back to address them this Christmas.
His empowerment program, if I must tell you the truth, is completely a complete deviation from what others have been doing. And having been elected by the Labour Nation, he sees his empowerment program as a program not only meant for the politicians, but meant for the numerous other rural people who went out there to say, let us vote in him as a senator. At that time, nobody, the Labour Nation didn't want to go to town more. So everybody worked. Regardless of the party people, what party people belong to, they voted for him. He now saw his empowerment program as something he should also do across party line. He came out and started at the market, empowering people, petty traders, who probably don't even have 5,000 naira of their own to trade, empowered all of them with over 20,000 naira each. And to, as far as I'm concerned, a lot of them are very happy that I've increased their Naira power for their business. And he did it across party line, didn't care whether it were PDP, APC, whatever it is, he did it across all of them. He did it in the market, Okada riders, he did it for them. Even at the university, at the churches, he did it for all of them. Because there's no way you can separate all these people at these various groups or association that is being placed. You can't go there and say this is APC, this is PDP, this is Labour Party. You cannot say that. Keep them across to everybody. So I think this empowerment program is highly laudable.
The empowerment programs, which has come in different phases, you may have been aware that one leg of the empowerment was the one we did across all the major markets. And of course, in every local government, in the data centers in Trans Street, we had also done empowerment for women at the ward level. In fact, across the 85 wards in data center, we have done empowerment to several number of women that were identified by the leadership of our party. And we have also taken that to communities, irrespective of the whether they belong to the APC or belong to or not. We have a scholarship scheme that is ongoing. We intend to give scholarship to 200 students that are studying Urubu language in Delta State University, Abraka. And then there's also a slot of about 400 scholarship for students of Delta Central region that are in Delta State University, Abraka.
The senator has also, right now there is currently registration ongoing for training of our people selected across the 8 local government areas in training in cosmetology, in the production and laying of caps and interlocking stones, training on installation of CCTV and other internet facilities, training on computer and ICT. That training is taking off this month. For some people, it will be 2 weeks, especially for those that are going to be engaged in cosmetology. And then for those that will be involved in other forms of training, like the ones involving the interlocking stone, training on CCTV and others, those ones will be 3 months. The total will be 150 for those selected in this first phase of the training. We have several initiatives that have been going on. We have consistently interacted with opinion leaders across the entire district, president generals, youth leaders, women leaders, to ensure that since the decision just go to Abuja to say what he wants to say, but he says exactly what the Urhobo people will wish that he will say in the National Assembly.
Of course, of course, of course. We've not had this kind of representation since the beginning of democracy. I know that between 1979 and 1983, when Senator Dafinane represented the Urhobos, Urhobos had a voice. But between 1999 and now, both for Viomagige going into the Senate, Urhobos had no voice. Senator Paul Sewerido tried to create a voice for the Urhobo nation, but his life was cut short. He could not actualize his dreams to have been seen the way Viomagige is seen today. So Viomagige has come out fully to represent the Urhobo nation very well. I'm sure he has created a milestone that other people who come after him in the future will be judged. Because within a short time, you can see how many bills he has sponsored and how actively he is involved in the Senate. We've never had it so good.
Very well, very well. The entire central could have had anything better. Couldn't have anything better. It's just a square peg in a square hole. It's the best that could have happened to his people of Delta Central. So they made the right choice, and like you hear everywhere, that they've never had it good, so good like this before. Floor of the Senate. In the past, we had senators represented the people of Delta Central, and nothing good had come out from their representation. But since Senator Viomagige, my boss, took over from Senator Mori, who went there to sleep, people of Delta Central have been very happy with the kind of robust representation he has.
One key challenge is the failure of governance at Delta State level. The failure of governance has increased the pressure on him from the people. In fact, many Urhobo people see him more or less like the Urhobo governor because there is no alternative place to go to seek for help. So every now and then you see people coming to request for assistance in the area of school fees, marriages and all whatnot. That to me is a challenge, and given the fact that he is currently the only elected APC official across Delta State, that in itself had brought a lot of pressure on him from across both central,
North and the South Senatorial District, even though he was elected by the Delta Central people to represent them. To me, we take it with a lot of equanimity, knowing that he was elected to do just that. We are constrained by the fact that we do not have as much resources to meet with all of the challenges that the people have brought before us, but to the best of his ability, he has been able to touch so many people and so many communities in several ways. In fact, you will be amazed to find out that many communities have even come that has no electricity, come to him to seek for help. And we have tried to do this in several places. In Ubia here, we have supplied several transformers. In Ugele, we have done that. Currently, I know that we are pursuing the one of Ofuma and all those communities along that Afisere, Ogboma, Aziz. We are also pursuing for transformer and for Ikre Jebo community in Ugele. Of course, the one in Udu is even much more worrisome. We Senator had tried to ensure that the BDC do the needful by reconnecting majority of the communities in Udu local government that were disconnected at the time. Right now, we're pursuing that of DSC and Okolo inland.
Very well. Sometimes you can't stay with him in a minute and you don't laugh. He's a very funny person. He's humorous. There's hardly any sentence in it without something that will not make you laugh. That's him saying something that will not make you laugh. He's down to earth. He's somebody who's also has listening ear of his aides that are working with him. Listening to whether you're small or big, listening to advice. Is somebody also seek for suggestions, irrespective of who you are? He seeks for suggestions, and at the end, he comes out with whatever decision that he wants to take. Is somebody that is a funny person. Somebody that you'd like to stay with?
Personally, yes. But those that don't know him will say, oh, he's a very straight person, does not joke, does not play. But I know when you meet him in this private capacity and he's unwinding, you'll be surprised at the level he can go to joke. He cracks jokes and he plays. It's fun to be with.
People in Delta Central and beyond believe that the senatorial district never had it so good until the arrival of Senator Vio Mwagege at the Senate. 2 years down the line and still counting on the achievements and success stories of quality representation of Senator Vio Mwagege at the Red Chamber.